Hi, my name is Michelle Dufty. I'm a Senior Director of Product Marketing with Sonatype. Today, I'd like to talk to you about how we integrate our automated open source governance solutions with MicroFocus Fortify. But before that, I'd like to talk a little bit about the open source market in general. It's interesting to note that today, business applications are actually under attack. 51% of enterprises suffered at least one breach in the last 12 months. 43% of those enterprise attacks are perpetrated by external actors, not by people within the organization. And 68% of external attacks target web applications for known vulnerabilities. So organizations used to put up big network firewalls, but the reality is that organizations go through digital transformations and more of their applications are now on the web. Bad actors are looking for known vulnerabilities within web applications and attacking those and going straight to the data source. And so what's happening because of that, established business leaders are also under attack. Since 2000, 52% of Fortune 500 have been replaced. And that's happening because, as I mentioned, organizations are going through digital transformations. And now almost every company in the world is actually a software company. And established leaders are being replaced by companies that can deliver applications, innovative applications faster. Think about Airbnb, Netflix, Uber, and so forth. They're actually replacing existing organizations because they come to the market with an application-focused first approach, and they're building all of these applications, and they're building them faster and more innovative. And the way they're doing that is that they're developing DevOps or DevSecOps practices. Today, we see that those winners are releasing great software faster and more securely than their competitors. So they want to innovate, they want to deliver faster, but they also want to make sure that they're doing it in a secure way. Organizations that go through DevOps transformations or DevSecOps transformations are building out CI/CD pipelines, and they're trying to release their software very quickly. The best release daily, some release monthly, but those that release quarterly or more are really being left behind. And they're doing that because, and they're able to do that faster because applications today are no longer written from scratch. They're actually assembled from third-party components. Everyone today uses open source software. There's no reason for a developer to rebuild something that's already been built. They want to focus on the part of the application that is specific to their business logic and that is makes them provides them competitive features. They want to borrow open source components on the part of the application that are common and can be reused. So basically, what does that mean? In an organization, about 85% of an application, the code in an application actually comes from open source components or is sourced from external suppliers. We like to view the software development lifecycle like a software supply chain. Not everything is built in-house, like I mentioned. You're getting those open source components from actual external suppliers. And basically, that means that every developer in your software supply chain is in procurement. They're out there choosing open source libraries. They're determining which supplier they're going to use. And they're bringing those open source components into your development lifecycle. At Sonatype, we are the caretakers of the central repository, which is the public repository for all Java open source components. And that gives us great visibility into the practices of organizations out there. As they automate their CI/CD pipelines, they're able to go and download open source components from Central much faster. And they're downloading them faster and faster, as you can see in this graph. In 2018, we saw 146 billion download requests from the Central repository. So the growth and the demand for open source components is just rising very quickly. In the same way, if you look at NPM, which is the public repository for JavaScript, they get about 7 billion download requests a week. And so the demand for these open source components is just staggering. And basically, that means that because there's such high demand, the project owners of these open source projects are now delivering about 15,000 new releases every day. That's interesting to note. There's about 19.5 million open source components out there with 15,000 new releases every day. There's only 25 million developers globally in the world. So you can just get a sense of the amount of open source components these developers are consuming into your their organizations. That's the good part, is that they're able to reuse software and deliver innovation more quickly. The bad part is that sometimes with open source, there comes some inherent risk. We like to say that open source ages like milk, not like wine. So we can see that of all of those Java component downloads, about 11.1% of those download requests actually have a known vulnerability. And it's even higher in the JavaScript world. About 51% of JavaScript packages downloaded annually per developer have a known vulnerability. So it's great that developers are using these open source components. It's enabling them to be innovative, but they have to think about what as someone in procurement, what they're bringing into the organization. And there needs to be kind of checks and balances to make sure that they're bringing in only the best and the highest quality open source components. And this is really important because what we've been seeing over time is that the attacks, the breaches in organizations is just happening faster and faster. You know, back in 2006, through an IBM report, we saw that it took about 45 days after a vulnerability was disclosed before someone actually got attacked or breached. But now, as late as 2017, with the Equifax breach, they had about 3 days. The Struts vulnerability that they were using was announced, and 3 days later, they were starting to be hacked. So the DevSecOps challenge for everyone is they have to automate faster than evil. If they're using automated CI/CD, then they can push out a new release much faster than if you're using old waterfall type methodologies. So organizations have to be aware of what they're using, know what their risk is, and then be able to fix it very quickly. So at Sonatype, we've developed a whole platform to automatically enforce open source policy and control risk across every phase of the SDLC. It's a complete integrated set of solutions designed to work together. The first solution is actually called Nexus Firewall. Nexus Firewall automatically stops risks from entering your software development lifecycle by enforcing policies when proxying to public repositories. So if you have an open source policy to not allow a vulnerable component with a CVSS score greater than 7, Firewall can actually block that component from being downloaded. We also have the Nexus repository, which centrally stores and manages all of your libraries and build artifacts across your entire software development lifecycle. And then we have Nexus Lifecycle that works at every phase in your development lifecycle to continuously identify risk, enforce policies, and remediate issues. We have Nexus Auditor, which is used to examine third-party applications or applications that are in production that aren't going through the software development lifecycle to see if there's any inherent risk in those. And all of this is 100% powered by Nexus Intelligence, which includes precise and actionable security, license, and quality metadata curated by more than 65 researchers. Nexus Lifecycle is an important part of our solution and is one of the ways that we integrate with HP Fortify. Nexus Lifecycle really starts with policy configuration. So as I mentioned, it enables you to automate and enforce your policy throughout the lifecycle, but first you have to be able to define your policy. And with Nexus Lifecycle, we have a very rich and flexible policy engine. It gives you the ability to create very customized policies based on app type and organization. They can be configured for security vulnerabilities, licenses, and to reduce technical debt. It's also the only solution where you can enforce those policies across every phase of your software development lifecycles. You can choose to set warnings with emails or create Jira tickets at some phases, or you could actually choose to fail builds at other phases based on the severity of the policy violation. And all of this is because of our very precise and actionable intelligence that we provide to Nexus Lifecycle to enable you to ensure that the data that we provide is accurate and so that you can take the right policy action. The next important part of Nexus Lifecycle is all of the reporting. So the first thing you have to do to understand if there's any risk in your applications is to have visibility into those open source components. And so by creating a software bill of material or identifying that risk, you can see a summary view of your security and license policy violations, and you can see that bill of materials to know exactly what's in your app and what open source components are included in that application. And as I mentioned, this is all done with our curated security data. The data that powers Nexus Lifecycle and the entire platform is curated by more than 65 security researchers 24/7. Their expert identification and remediation guidance makes everyone, including developers, a security and license expert. And we provide that data through reporting and dashboards, but also directly to the developer within their IDE and even through a GitHub pull request. The remediation guidance, as you can see, was designed so that developers can easily understand what the vulnerability is and how they should resolve it. Our researchers spend a lot of time making sure that the vulnerability description, the explanation, the detection, and the recommendation is written in a way that it's very easy for developers to take action and continue to move that build throughout the SDLC. It's also important to note that Nexus integrates early and everywhere with your favorite pipeline tools. The entire solution works with your favorite DevOps tools out of the box. No need for your development, security, or ops teams to learn a new tool. Our platform is uniquely architected to enforce policy and provide open source intelligence and remediation guidance right at your fingertips. And as you can see, we have an integration out of the box with Micro Focus Fortify to give Fortify customers a comprehensive view of both the vulnerabilities in the source code that developers write, as well as the open source vulnerabilities that they borrow from public repositories. The integration is available out of the box if you're a Nexus Lifecycle customer. Lifecycle scans come into Fortify via an IQ Fortify integration service. The data then is mapped to the IQ Fortify parser plugin and then is available to Fortify SSC customers right in the SSC dashboard. All of the intelligence about the component and the metadata around the open source components and the vulnerabilities are all hosted in Nexus Intelligence, which is a Sonatype hosted data services in the cloud. So here you can see an example of what that looks like. This is the Fortify SSC dashboard. This is a drill down specifically into a vulnerable open source component from the Sonatype Nexus Lifecycle solution. It's one place for your security experts to get both open source and proprietary vulnerabilities in a single dashboard. So you get that complete view of the inherent risk within your application. The risk of, as I mentioned, the code that developers are writing from scratch, as well as the open source code that they're actually procuring from other repositories. You can see if I drill into a vulnerable OSS component that was identified via a Sonatype, you can see that it's a critical vulnerability. I can see the description of the vulnerability. I can get some information about the actual component details. It's a Java component called Bouncy Castle. I can see if there's any effective licenses, when it was created. I can go directly to the website for this component if I need to. I can also then identify the issue, the CVE number, the CVSS score, the source of the data, and get a high-level overview of what's going on in terms of the risk with that component. But then I can get the full Sonatype scan report by clicking on the report URL and go into the Lifecycle solution where I can get a complete software bill of materials for that application and identify specifically this Bouncy Castle component. I can then drill into all of the policy violations. I can view them by severity. I can see the inherent risk. I can also see the recommendations for how to remediate. So with this Nexus Lifecycle and Micro Focus Fortify joint solution, you have a single view into your open source and proprietary vulnerabilities in a single dashboard. If you'd like to learn more about how Sonatype works with Micro Focus Fortify, you can please visit us at sonatype.com. Thank you.